Rocky reef habitat is the habitat that is used by things like pawa and crayfish and fish as their feeding ground. Once we understood the value of what was being lost and we had worked out how much habitat that we needed to replace, we needed to figure out how to design a new habitat that would give us the best outcome. We looked at various options to be able to do that, including things like stormwater treatment, creating a mussel bed.
And the stormwater turned out to be more expensive than it had initially been planned, so it wasn't affordable. And as we got further into the detail of how you would deliver it, the benefits became smaller and smaller. So you were paying a lot more for a lot less. So at that point, we looked around and said, we've got to find something.
And on balance, when we looked across those options, the artificial reef was not only going to be cheaper, but it was also going to give us better ecological outcomes. And it was much more similar to what we were losing. We were losing rocky reef habitat. And so this was effectively recreating rocky reef habitat, which was also really high value.
Parts of our iwi are very, very strong in the knowledge of our harbour and some of the mātauranga Māori, the mata uruura that goes with it. We know where our mahinga kai are, we know where our kina are, we know where our pāua are, we know where to fish for certain types of fish species. When we talk to mata uruura, our mātauranga Māori, it's actually the transfer of that knowledge from that particular karaua who was a fisherman who's passed it from son to grandson and so forth.
It's been really exciting to work with the cultural monitors and mana whenua to learn more about the mātauranga and the local knowledge in Te Whanganui-a-Tara.
What I've enjoyed the most about this is actually dealing with the Western science side of things, bringing mātauranga Māori, Western science together. We can collaborate to work out what the perfect outcome is, then we all win.
The reef units are made of precast concrete. And they're cast over in Seaview, and then they delivered on a barge to this side of the harbour, and where they're put into the harbour water.
It's made out of concrete to promote seaweed growth as well as provide a self-supporting structure. Concrete also allows us to create the complex geometric shapes that allow water to flow through the device and also for it to found itself firmly on the seabed.
So in the first year the reef units are in place, we expect to see some of the early colonisers show up, so different algal species, sponges, sea squirts, some of those early bifouling species. From there we'll see some smaller fish, like spotties and tripofins, and then as the reef gets more established, that's when we'll start to see more kutai, the mussels, other large brown macroalgae, and then some of the larger fish species like the tamure, the snapper, blue cod, tarakihi, and that they will become more resident.
There's lots of examples of successful reef enhancements around the world. So a good example is King Reef in Western Australia. They found that even within a few months, there were over 20 species that had colonised the reef units. So we're hoping and expect to see the same type of outcome for this reef enhancement.
It's really exciting to see a large-scale infrastructure project like Te Ara Tupua have a positive impact on marine ecology and wanting to do something more for future generations.
Really enjoyed seeing the multiple benefits that the project brings, not just for the ecology, but also for our community, for mana whenua, for school kids, and also that it's providing resilience to our infrastructure. A strong desire from everyone in the team to leave behind something better